Pitkän talven jälkeen lähteenä korven matkalla. Kesäseuraradio.
Seurateltassa alkaa siis nyt iltahartaus, jossa puhuu Juha Luokkala.
Seurat jatkuvat iltahartaudella, jonka jälkeen seurateltassa on laulutuokio. Laulamme Sionin laulun 219. Laulun jälkeen iltahartauden pitää veljemme Juha Luokkala. Sionin laulu 219.
As we continue these services still in this evening devotion, I will ask to read from these Acts of Apostles from chapter 16, verses 22-34, and the words are in Jesus' name. And the multitude rose up together against them, and the magistrates rent off their clothes and commanded to beat them. And when they had laid many stripes upon them, they cast them into prison, charging the jailer to keep them safely. Who, having received such a charge, thrust them into the inner prison and made their feet fast in the stocks. And at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed and sang praises unto God, and the prisoners heard them. And suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundations of the prison were shaken, and immediately all the doors were opened, and everyone's bands were loosed. And the keeper of the prison awakened out of his sleep, and seeing the prison doors open, he drew out his sword and would have killed himself, supposing that prisoners had been fled. But Paul cried with a loud voice, saying, "Do thyself no harm, for we are all here." Then he called for light and sprang in and came trembling and fell down before Paul and Silas and brought them out and said, "Sirs, what must I do to be saved?" And they said, "Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved, and thy house." And they spake unto him the word of the Lord, and to all that were in his house. And he took them the same hour of the night, and washed their stripes, and was baptized, and he and all his straightway. And when he had brought them into his house, he set meat before them and rejoiced, believing in God with all his house. Amen. Paul's service travels were very colorful. There were these nice experiences, and there were also harsh experiences. God knew what is to happen to Paul when he asked him to God's kingdom's work. Today we might ask, what might be so important that when God knew that Paul, when he died through a death of martyr, he still went to preach the gospel. This gospel, the gift of faith, is so precious that this life is a great gift, but much smaller than this faith and that which we receive as a prize. And now, as Paul and Silas were on the service travel, God guided their moments, and Paul wanted to trust in God, and only in God, and he many times in his own weakness and of his own sinfulness complained, and many times also the previous saints complained how poor and weak they are to preach the gospel, but when God strengthens, he moves. And as we have started these Jämsä Opisto services also, it is very miraculous that they are not any kind of miraculous acts, but year after year, children of God want to gather together to listen to the simple word of the word of God, word that does not change, that has no new versions, but the same word is preached over and over again. And this miraculous matter when Paul preached the gospel and there were people who repented and who received the gospel, for example, before this story, Lydia received the grace of repentance. Services were held immediately, and there were also baptisms there, and it was good to be there. And in this way, in the work of God's kingdom, we proclaim this gospel message, and we stop to hear this, and also this saying in the Bible that we would not forsake these words, and that we would get strength for our faith through these Bible words, and you have done good that you have come to these services. It was said here how Paul was beat harshly, and when he was preaching there on the streets, this kind of woman who was a slave for her was serving as a slave, and she followed him, Paul, and she said that these men are the children of God, or the sons of a higher God. Paul listened to this for a while, but then through the power of God, put this spirit away. And I think that this work of God's kingdom, we don't go with the doctrines of this world, but we preach from the kingdom of God, that gospel. We do work together with our sisters and brothers, the gospel work, and in this way, mission work of God's kingdom. Paul experienced through the people, they were, they got flustered because this woman was not with them, and all these people were against Paul and Silas, and they were so furious and flustered that they beat them, and they were not listening to them, and they threw them into prison, or cast them into prison. And here it was done wrong, even against the law of Roman. And if they knew this, they would have not done this. But Paul, afterwards, if we would read furthermore, Paul would say there that they did wrong, or you did wrong, that these Paul said that it is not right that we would go away from this prison, that we belong in this prison because we have done wrong. And these men said that, come away from the prison. And that's when Paul with Silas went away from the prison. And even today we, as we organize these services in a free, beloved motherland, in all peace, we are protected by the law to gather together and proclaim God's word and believe as before. It is a great gift of God. We do not need to fear today, as Paul had to, that services would be stopped. This great of a gift God has given to us here in Finland. Paul experienced this kind of torture, and Jesus, before the crucifixion, it was a harsh punishment, and sometimes people even died of this. They were beaten in their wounds, and the dungeons were not the same as they are here today. They were much worse, and Paul and Silas were put there in such a prison where their feet were fast in stocks. And when midnight came, Paul and Silas, and their human portion came when light faded away, and they pondered what will happen now, and they started to pray, and they started to sing. God strengthened Paul and Silas. Just think, dear brothers and sisters, what kind of situation they were in. They had all kinds of wounds and a harsh situation, but how they were comforted with the God's Spirit, how it strengthened when they prayed to God, and how those songs also surely comforted Paul and Silas, and also those other prisoners listened to these songs. And these songs were songs of Zion and hymns. And in the kingdom of God, it is a central role, this praising of God through songs. And also these prayers, they are songs. When it is difficult for us to continue on our way in life or faith, and that is when a song is a beautiful gift for us people. So then they sang, and God heard their prayers, and he strengthened them. And then a miracle happened, and there was a great earthquake, and the foundations of the prison were shaken, and all the doors were opened, and everyone's bands were loosed. This situation was miraculous or astonishing. God could have said that on Silas to go away from the prison, but they were in no hurry. They stayed in the prison, and when the keeper woke up of his sleep, and he saw these prison doors open, and everyone's bands were loosed, and he was afraid that all the prisoners had fled, so he would have killed himself. The gospel here, I think, it brings to mind the loosening of the bands, of the power of the gospel, how through the Holy Ghost preached gospel, the comforting message, it opens these bands. if we say our own psalms and put away our sins, it gives strength on the way of our faith. This gospel, it is a beautiful gift to us. And also this gospel, when it is preached to unbelievers, he who believes, as God preaches this message, that all sins are forgiven in Jesus' name and atonement blood. The spiritual dungeon, the prisoner of the devil, is freed to joy, to the joy and freedom of God's children. Such a joyous message or power is this gospel's message. And then this keeper was scared and was about to kill himself, but when Paul saw this, he cried with a loud voice, saying, "Do thyself no harm, for we are all here." When Paul saw that this poor person is killing himself, is going from time to everlasting time in the state of unbelief, with his loud voice said, wanted to stop this from happening. It was the mind of Christ. We remember how Jesus also prayed on behalf of his own, tormentors, and forgave all their acts, and he strengthened all the love, and he had this same love for the keeper also, just before they had beat Paul and Silas with their feet fast in the stocks, but Paul didn't mind. He wanted to save this man, and this was influenced by the Holy Spirit. It does work through love, and in this way, the God's kingdom, it is known through love, known of love. And as in these services, this text is speaking of love, and it is the fruit of faith, and it is seen in God's children, and it is also seen in Paul. And this keeper then went inside when he heard Paul's voice, and he asks, "What must I do to be saved?" What a great question. What must I do to be saved? And when this question is set with this kind of mind state of mind, whatever the answer it is, he wants to do it. This keeper did not have the state of mind of this rich young man who asked Jesus that, "What must I do to be saved?" He was also rich spiritually, and he was not ready to repent. But this keeper of the prison was fully hänellä mitä olisi Jumala eteen voinut tuoda. Ja silloin hän kysyi näin, että mitä pitää tehdä. He was fully stripped and he had nothing he could do. And he asked, "What must I do to be saved?" And they said, "Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and thou shalt be saved in thy house." Very simple message of God's kingdom, it is preached, this kind of simple message of the forgiveness of sins, that Christ has won the power of sin and death and opened the way to everlasting life in heaven. And he has given to his own kingdom, a duty to preach this forgiveness of sins to all, to everyone, and this message is for all. He who wants to believe can believe, all sins forgiven, in Jesus' name and blessed atonement blood. And through believing this, you can enter God's kingdom as God's child, and one day receive the prize of everlasting life in heaven. Jesus preaches of this simple message of faith when the disciples returned, that the people obeyed them, and Jesus said that, remember the most important, that your own name is written on the book of life. And this gospel, this message is for the childlike children of God. And even at this evening moment, it is meant for all, everyone who hears this sermon, even you who have not received peace and joy on your conscience. That kind of peace and joy that this keeper of the prison experienced when he brought Paul and Silas to his own house, and services were kept once again, and the Lord's word was spoken there, and the services were all day. It was good to hear God's word, and there was no hurry anywhere. And this kind of peace we experience in God's kingdom. Righteousness, peace, and joy. And even the disciples here there said that it is good to be here, even here at Jämsä Opisto services. It is good for us to be here in the midst of God's children and hear the word of the Good Shepherd and hear this good message. Even you who want to receive this peace on your conscience, you can believe all your sins forgiven in Jesus' name and blood. And as the Bible says, to follow the Lord Jesus and us, God's children, to our heavenly home. And then it was still said here that the services were held there and they were baptized. And of this baptism, it was said that God's children want to baptize their children here in Finland. And also when from the life of unbelief you repent and you haven't been baptized and want to be baptized, in the Bible it is said in the letter of Peter, book of Peter, that not that these filthiness would be taken away, but it is the good bind of conscience and the way of faith is started for this keeper of the prison, and as it is for us also, it is with our Lord Jesus Christ. We have no reason to worry. He strengthens us in our weak moments when we trust in him, just as the previous saints did. And also other people in the Bible were scared in many situations where people forsake Jesus, but Jesus never forsake people, but Jesus preached once again, and it was a time for services again, where God's love was spoken of. Dear brothers and sisters, we are on our way to heaven, and God gives strength for our faith. every day. We do not need to worry about tomorrow, but as in the Bible it is said that every day has its own worries, but God has promised to keep us in his blessed hand, under his blessed hand. And Jesus said of his own disciples, of us, you and me, God who has given you is greater than anyone, and no one can take them away from my God's hand. And this is what state is for God's child. And we can be sure of this, that we will reach heaven. God's power carries us, and this gospel, let it be comforting even this evening moment, all of you there on the radio, as here at Jämsä Opisto Services, everywhere where this sermon is heard, all your sins can be forgiven in Jesus' name and blood, and you can be comforted, trusting in God's power, trusting that he binds those wounds and brings us home one day to everlasting home. And there we are on our way. And I myself want to ask also, as I have come here, that can I also believe all my sins forgiven? I want to believe together with you, and in this way we can securely trust in God's grace and in his power. In Jesus' name, amen. Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this service day. We thank you that you have promised to be with us every day until the end of our lives. You have promised to give us strength in our faith. You see everything. You see our battles. Strengthen us, dear Father, so that we would never forsake this faith and leave this kingdom, this beautiful kingdom, that we would keep this as our most precious treasure. Dear Heavenly Father, here in this evening moment, bless us and our loved ones, and invite them to your kingdom who have given up their faith. Father, you also know my situation, everything that is in my life and what will happen. I will leave my life, everything that is in it, in your loved arms, beloved arms. Thank you that you have promised to help and hear our prayers. We keep ourselves and our loved ones and everything on your hands. Thank you that you hear our prayers and bring us to your heavenly home. The Lord bless us and keep us. The Lord make his face shine upon us and be gracious unto us. Lord, lift up his countenance upon us and give us peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Iltahartauden piti Juha Luokkala. Seuraavaksi teltassa jatkuu ilta laulutuokio.
Laulamme Sionin laulun 215. Laulun jälkeen seurateltassa alkaa laulutuokio. Sionin laulu 215.